Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to find measures or graph angles in standard position. Okay, so the instructions are as follows. We have to find the measure of each angle with the indicated terminal side and angle swept. Okay, now let's take a look at question number one. This is the initial side on 0 degrees on the positive x-axis. And this is the terminal side right here. The angle swept is indicated by the red spiral. So we have one complete rotation and another complete rotation with another angle left over here. Okay? So how many degrees is two complete full circular rotations? That's equivalent to the first circular rotation is 360 degrees because we know that the full circle is 360. That's for this. If this were the terminal side, the angle will be 360 degrees. If you rotate again to this point, the second full rotation, you add another 360, that's equivalent to 720 degrees. Okay? Now here you have 720 degrees. Now if this is 720 degrees right here, let me reposition the angular measure. So this right here is 720 after two rotations. If I go another quarter of a full circle, how many degrees is a quarter of a circle? A quarter of a circle is 90 degrees. So if I go on a quarter of a circle after two full circular rotations, I'll add 90 to that. This angle right here will be 720 plus 90, which is 810 degrees. Okay, so it's going to be 810 degrees up here. Now if you look at this blue angular measure that's given to us, we're told that to get to the terminal side, you have to take out 75 degrees from this angle right here. That will take you to your terminal side. Okay, we need to back up a little bit. So what do we get if we start from 810 and back up 75 degrees? All you simply do is you subtract, right? So you have 810 degrees, which is two full circular rotations and a quarter of a rotation. And then you're going to subtract the green angle indicated here, minus 75. And then just do the arithmetic. That will give you the value of our terminal side. Okay, so 5, and then here, you have 735 degrees is your angular measure. Okay, so your terminal side is 735 degrees, and that's your answer. The terminal side is at 735 degrees. Okay, let's take a look at question number two. In question two, we have a rotation going downwards. Now, when you rotate downwards, how does that impact the sine of your angular value? If you rotate upwards as indicated in problem number one, that is a positive angular direction, okay? So if you rotate in this direction, that's positive. But if you rotate in the clockwise direction, that is negative. Okay, so you have to pay attention to the direction of the spiral when determining the value of the angular measure of your terminal side. Now, if you notice, we have a complete rotation right here. If you have a complete rotation from this is zero, and then you rotate all the way to here, how many degrees is that? That is negative 360 degrees. A full circular rotation in the clockwise direction is negative 360 degrees. Now, if we go a quarter of a circle, this would be minus 90, which is negative 450. All right, we're not there yet. Another quarter of a circle to right here, you subtract another 90 degrees. That gives you negative 540 degrees. Now, you notice the green arrow is in the direction of our rotation. It tells us that if we stop at negative 540, in order to get to our terminal side, what are we to do? Add or subtract 65. You notice this is 65 more than where you stopped at, so you have to subtract another 65 degrees in order to get to your terminal site. This is because the direction is counterclockwise. So if you're going counterclockwise, you subtract, right? As we did over here. Now let's find out the measure. We're going to have negative 540. And what are we going to do? We are going to subtract 65. And our final answer is as though we are adding, right? So 506 negative. Negative 605 degrees. All right, so for number two, the terminal side, is negative 605 degrees. All right, let's take a look at question number three. So question three, we do not have any complete spiral rotation here. Actually, all we have is just a quarter of a circle. So if you notice the direction of rotation, this is zero, the initial side. If you rotate downwards, remember that's a negative direction, okay, which will yield a negative angular value for our terminal side. So we rotated clockwise and stopped here. All right, we know it's going to be somewhere 90, less than 90 degrees. So the angle in green is telling us how many degrees we're rotating clockwise to get to the terminal side. So the terminal side is right here. So it starts from this angular value right here and you subtract 130. So how many degrees are you going in the clockwise direction to get this value? Where are you starting from? Well, let's figure out what that is. If this is zero, this right here is negative 90 degrees. This right here is negative 180. So if you start from negative 180 and you rotate counterclockwise, which is a positive directional rotation, how many degrees will you have left is the question. All right, so all you do is you take the entire rotation, which is negative 180. That will take you from here all the way to this side. Now, if you go counterclockwise 130 degrees, that is equivalent to adding 130 degrees. Okay? So if you do that, you do your calculations, you end up with negative 50 degrees. All right, so your terminal side right here is negative 50 degrees. Okay? So let's write that down. For number three, terminal side. Negative 50 degrees. All right, let's take a look at question number four. Question number four is unique because this one is in radian form, okay? And working in radian is a little bit cumbersome because you have to deal with fractions and it's not that easy to, add fractions repeatedly. So one easy way to solve problems of this nature is to convert your question to degrees. And then convert your final answer back to radians. Okay? So what is pi over 3 in degree form? Let's go ahead and do the conversion. Pi over 3. In degrees, I'm going to multiply by 180 over pi. The pi's cancel out. 3 goes here 1, 3 goes here 60. And your final answer is 60 degrees. Okay? So this is telling me that I'm going to be rotating I'm rotating clockwise 60 degrees. Okay? Since I'm going in that direction, it's going to be negative 60. Okay? So going, remember, if you go counterclockwise is negative, if you go clockwise is positive. Now let's shift our attention to the terminal side. It involves one complete rotation and then three-quarter of a circle all the way down here. So what is that going to be? If I complete one full rotation in the counterclockwise direction, that is equivalent to 360 degrees. Okay? And then we're going to go a quarter of a circle here to This is 360 at 90 degrees, that gives you 450. At another 90 degrees, that's 510. At another 90 degrees, that gives you, let's see, quick correction here, this is 540, not 510. If you add 90 to 450 degrees, that takes you to 540. So this is 540. At another 90, that takes you to 630. Okay? Now, how many degrees is left here? You notice that this entire quadrant right here is 90 degrees, right? So 60 degrees is taken up. How many degrees do you have left here to rotate? If this is 60, in order to complete 90, this tiny piece right here must be 30 degrees. Okay, so the angular rotation you have left here is 30 degrees. So if you add that 30 that's left, this is 30. How do you know it's 30? Because these two add up to 90. So if you add the 30 that's left to the 630, where does that take you? It takes you to 660 degrees. Okay, another way you can do that is you add another 90 to this. That will give you 720. And then when you get to 720, you subtract 60 degrees to back up all the way here, and you end up with 660 degrees. Okay, now this is 660 degrees, that's our terminal site in degrees. How do we express it in radian form? So in radians, all right, so in radians, 660 degrees should be multiplied by 180, I mean pi over 180 degrees. Okay, pi over 180 degrees. The degrees cancel out the zeros. We can reduce by 6, but let's multiply across first. If we multiply across, we'll have 66 pi over 18. Divide the numerator and the denominator by 6, you end up with 11 pi over 3. All right, so there goes your terminal side. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to my channel by clicking here. More tips can be found on mathyourself.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.